It's the end of an era. The tale is about to turn for the druids of Lemar. Trouble comes first from their western frontier as a rival pack challenges their border. The invaders sense that without their old leaders, the druids are not the clan they used to be. But the druids rally, and with a quick council, swing into action. Evenly matched, neither clan will cross the border. And for now, the druids hold the line. The druids have made a kill, and this time leave plenty for the coyote couple. But there's never enough for everyone. The male coyote takes his to go. Now the eagle can move in, but even he can't eat in peace. The female coyote takes a modest share, but keeps an eye out for trouble. When it strikes, she can't see it coming. The male hangs on tight to his prize, while the female washes away all that's left of hers. As winter retreats from Lemar, a new threat to the druids invades the valley. A strong pack of 15 from Slough Creek to the north. They're already deep into druid territory, intent on conquest. The druids respond, but their strength is diminished. Now they are only 9. The Sloughs can hear the druids' weakness and attack. Though outnumbered, the druids set out to meet them. Tails waving high with confidence, the Sloughs smell victory. But the druids are fighting for everything they own. The battle begins in confusion. The young druids don't know what to do. Then the chief of the Sloughs takes charge, attacking the druids' new leader. The druids are on the run. The best they can do is escape with their lives. The once mighty druid clan scatters. Bound for hard times, they head into exile. The sloughs begin to gather. They've done what no other pack has been able to do in almost 10 years. They've broken the druids and taken Lemar, the greatest prize in Yellowstone. And they know it. Their victory celebration is loud and long. For the coyotes, it's a seismic change. The druids were the devil they knew. What kind of overlords will the Slough Creek wolves be? They've already made a kill. And the male coyote moves in as usual. This time, it's a terrible mistake. Flush with their new power, the sloughs set out to deliver a message. They show no mercy. The female coyote has no choice but to flee. She looks for her mate, but he won't be coming. The female must carry on alone. Soon she will have pups to care for, but she won't have them here with the sloughs in charge. Turning south, she heads into unfamiliar country, into the interior of Yellowstone. Water becomes winter's frozen highways. And she tracks along the Yellowstone River for almost 20 miles. This icy road leads her directly to the base of the upper falls. It's a rugged climb, but in these dark, quiet woods, she is not the only traveler. A red fox has found a carcass and is scavenging a meal. For the fox, the coyote is not a welcome sight. She's as intimidating to him as a wolf is to the coyote. But the fox knows how to make it here, in the dead of winter, on his own. He ventures out into the bright expanse of Hayden Valley. This is Yellowstone's high plateau, almost 8,000 feet in elevation. While winter is retreating down in Lemar, it hangs on here with a vengeance. Weighing a mere 10 pounds or so, the fox steps lightly on the frozen crust. His prey is protected by a good 3 feet of snow. Yet with only sensitive ears and a pointy nose, the fox is well prepared. At 30 pounds, the coyote keeps breaking through the crusty snow. Her strategy is to dig. And dig. And dig. But in the end, it's worth it. Bison spend the winter here, breaking trail and pushing snow. It takes all their massive strength to reach the meager grass below. The elk left Hayden months ago. Only one other creature can match the bison's ability to endure. The winter wolves of Hayden. This small but remarkable band has made an extraordinary choice. Instead of taking on other wolves for the riches of Lemar, they stay here and take on the fiercest prey. These wolves survive on bison. There is little for the coyote here. It's hard enough for the wolves. This tough little band hasn't had many pups and hasn't grown any larger. Hayden Valley may not provide enough nutrition for them at the right time of year. Still, they've managed to bring down a bison. But the coyote's had enough of wolves. She needs to find a den site, some safe place to have her pups.